So today we will see the basics of DFT. So this video has three parts. At first, the basic understanding of DFT, then which functional you should choose for your work. For those of you who don't know what a functional is, you will understand it by seeing the video. And finally, a practical example of how to really work with DFT. So at first, the basic understanding of DFT. So what is DFT? See, up to one electron problem, we can solve the Schrodinger equation exactly. You can see the Schrodinger equation of hydrogen atom here. Now see, there are two points. In any atom other than hydrogen, there are many electrons. Okay, and in any practical system you are working, there are thousands and millions of atoms and molecules. Okay, so you cannot solve it exactly. And even if you think that I will write Schrodinger equation for each electron, proton and neutron and then I will solve, even for the fastest computer in the world, it will take nearly 7 years. Okay, so we have to involve some approximation and tricks. Now at first comes the Born-Oppenheimer approximation. It says that the electronic wave function depends upon the nuclear position. It's okay, but it does not depend upon their velocities. Actually, the nucleus is so much heavy that it cannot move so fast, and that's why it cannot affect the electronic wave function much. Okay, so you can take this approximation. And then comes the Hohenberg-Kohn theorem. It says that the electron density of any system determines all the ground state properties of the system. Now see, if you know the electron density, you know everything, right? So we shall use electron density as a functional, and finally we shall calculate all other ground state properties. Okay, so another thing you have to know is, what is exchange correlation functional? Now see, two electrons not only interact by their electronic charge, but also by their spins, right? So now see, Pauli exclusion says that two electrons cannot stay in the same energy state. So if the two electrons are staying in the same energy state, they have to stay with opposite spin. So we can say that opposite spins attract and the parallel spins repulse, right? So if you want to know the exchange interaction with it deeply, then you can go to the quantum mechanics book of Dr. Griffith, and you can check it there in the chapter identical particles. And now see, the exchange correlation functional is an approximation that takes care of all the quantum mechanical information, right? Okay, so there are the main equations of DFT. So now you can see it's just like a Schrodinger equation. It is the kinetic energy term, and here are the potential energy terms. Now Vxc is the exchange correlation potential. Okay, so this is the Hadley potential and this is the external influence. So the exchange correlation functional is defined as, so this is Exc, we call this the actually the exchange correlation functional, and Vxc is defined as delta Exc by delta n. Okay, so now which functional you should choose for your work? Okay, we will see how many functionals are there and everything, but for the people who want a one-line answer, the one-line answer is, you can either choose B3 leaf or B3 PW. These are the best option for you, but no presently existing functional is highly accurate for all properties of interest. Of course, no functional can be 100% accurate for everything, right? So what you have to do, you take some experimental data available. It can be some paper, it can be some experimental data of your own, and then match your DFT calculation result with this experimental data. So for whichever approximation it matches the most, you can take it. But again, there will always be new problems to deal with. So let's check the next slide. This is the Jacob's ladder of Exp functional. You know what a Jacob's ladder is? You can do some Wikipedia. So it actually connects from earth to heaven. Okay, so now our earth is Hadley approximation, which is the simplest, and the heaven of chemical accuracy. We want to reach the practical. Okay, so in the left hand side you have the simplicity increasing downwards, and in the right hand side the accuracy is increasing upwards. Okay, so if you use LDA approximation, now see, LDA is called local density approximation. If you use LDA, you will conserve time, that's okay, but you have to think whether your system is okay with LDA approximation or not. For many systems, the LDA approximation is absolutely fine. Okay, so LDA system takes electron density as a functional, only that, nothing more. Now comes GGA. This is called generalized gradient approximation. It takes, you can see, it takes the grad of electron density. Okay, so it includes a first order correction for, okay, it will take a more time from LDA, but it is more correct for any system. Okay, but it can happen that for your system, whatever result you are getting with LDA, you are getting the same result with GGA, then there is no point in using GGA, right? So that's what you have to take care of. And then comes meta GGA here. So meta GGA takes care of second order correction also. Then comes hyper GGA, which includes both the LDA approximation, GGA and hat tree approximation in a certain mixture. Okay, now suppose for B3 leaf, there is 20% hat tree approximation considered. Okay, so this B3 leaf is the, as I told before, is the one line answer for who don't want to think about that which approximation they should choose. Okay, some people may tell you that what you can do is you can calculate your ground state energy, and for whichever approximation your ground state energy is minimum, you can take that as correct. But what happens in practical, for many approximations, the ground state energy looks similar. Okay, so then you cannot decide. Okay, then finally comes generalized random phase. It is actually second order molar preset correction. Maybe in another video we can tell you that what is this actually. So it includes the dispersion corrections. Okay, so let's go to the next slide. So we'll go to an example of how to really work with DFT. Now see, this is a paper published in Nano Letters. This is actually of WH2, which is a very well known material. Okay, so what you have to do in any DFT package you are using, you have to give an input of atomic position like this. Okay, here. So for this, and they had calculated the band structure here. Okay, but for anything you are calculating, you have to give an input of atomic positions. Okay, so you can use any molecule editing software like Vesta, Avogadro, and then you can extract the position in your suitable format. Like maybe in your package, I don't know what package you are using, maybe in your package the suitable format is .xyz, it can be .stl, right? Okay, so then you can calculate anything you want. Here they have calculated also partial density of states. Okay, so and after that they had published a paper. So what you have to do, just find a suitable package for your work. For any question regarding DFT or from this video, please comment us in the comment box below. Please subscribe to our channel, it's completely free and help our channel growing up. Thanks a lot.